Welcome back to part four in the series on food choices and human health. Now we're going to be discussing the components of a nutritious diet. I want to start with looking at what a whole food is compared to what a processed food is. And that's not exactly black and white. There's a spectrum between whole food and processed food, and there's a lot in between. What you want to focus on is eating whole food and very lightly processed food and staying away from the heavily processed items. When we think of whole food, of course, we're going to think of whole vegetables, whole fruits, whole beans, meat without it going through any sort of processing. When we get into items such as dairy, yogurts, highly processed, especially most of the sugar-laden yogurts. Milk is a fairly processed food as well, most of your soy and almond milks. And those are going to be the more moderate to lightly processed. When we get to, you know, the end of the spectrum, you think, you know, Twinkies and Ding Dongs, but in the middle of the spectrum is also going to be things like whole wheat bread. And we'll talk about in more detail when we get to carbohydrates why that is considered a very processed food. Now, these are examples of our packaged and processed foods, and they're extreme examples. I think everybody knows that M&M's, Reese's, Twix, all these candy bars are not good for you, so that's going to be our other extreme. And just remember, everything exists on a spectrum, so it's not exactly black and white. So what is processed? Now, bread, just like I said, is a very good example. And when you look at bread, I want you to think of what it's made of. This looks like a whole wheat bread, correct? But what is wheat? What exactly does a wheat plant look like? Well, it's a kernel, and there's no kernels in this bread. So what they do is they take those kernels, they put it through a process, actually many processes, and they reformulate it back into make bread. And we'll get into this in chapter four. The coloring is usually darker because of caramel color, sometimes molasses. I don't want you to be fooled by whole wheat breads. They are a very refined or processed item. They usually, remember, the five ingredients or less. Next time you pick up your favorite loaf of bread, I want you to look at the ingredients and count how many are in there and see how many you recognize as well. Also see how often sugar occurs. And we'll do this exercise a little bit later as well. Yogurt, like I said, dairy. A lot of dairy is highly processed. I call yogurt refrigerated ice cream because most yogurt is. If you get a plain Greek yogurt, that's a little bit different. That's more lightly processed, probably a little bit more healthy for you. But most of the flavored yogurts are almost the equivalent of ice cream. It's just the refrigerated version. So again, start looking on the ingredient list. Start looking at how much sugar is included, how much sugar is added, how much corn syrup is in there. Cereals, this is another favorite. Now, of course, the blueberries are a whole food, but these are corn flakes here. Now, what part of this flake looks like corn? Is any part of that flake look like corn? So that's what I want you, when you're looking at a product and saying, is this whole or processed, think about how it would look as it existed in nature. This corn flakes are a highly, highly processed food. It does not resemble corn by any stretch of the imagination. And most cereals are generally, you know, as good for you as a lot of the items you'll find on the dessert aisle. So cereals, again, highly processed items, usually a lot of added sugar. And then bagel and bread. Again, these are similar, but a lot of people, just like we went over earlier, a lot of people will grab for that bagel, thinking they're making a healthy choice, when generally, especially a bagel, if you have a big old thick layer of cream cheese on there, you are getting closer to, you know, the donut category as far as your nutrition. So I want to go through just an idea of how a food occurs in nature and the type of processing it can go through, and some of these are going to be obvious. But when we look at an orange, and we know it has vitamin C, We know it has phytonutrients in it. It also has fiber. If you eat the whole orange, you're going to be obtaining all those nutrients. Now, probably the most commonly processed food from an orange is orange juice. And we'll talk a little bit later why juices are generally not a good choice, and it's because of so much sugar in them. But it goes through a pasteurization process. Aside from being squeezed, which is a process, there's pasteurization, which does damage some of the vitamin C that you're getting from this orange. And it eliminates the fiber. So if you have more pulp in there, you'll get more fiber, but you're starting to take away nutrients. So every step in processing is taking away those nutrients. So you want to get as many nutrients as you can out of food. Okay, so now we jump to an orange marmalade. And I know here we're going through a lot more processing. There's a lot less of the original orange in here and a lot more sugar. And it's gone through more processing. So now we're at a point where we have very few, less vitamin C, fewer phytonutrients, no fiber at all. And now we're starting to add things in. And sugar, sugar, sugar in this one. And of course, our last example, the orange cream Pop-Tarts. Okay, so there's probably not any of the original orange in here. Well, maybe they took a little bit of the orange peel and made it for flavor, or maybe it was just synthetically created in a lab. But this, you know, this is the extreme version. But you can see the in-between steps. So again, when you look at food, I want you to think how far it came from how it existed in nature. And every step along the way, you lose nutrients and you also gain some added things such as sugar and processed fats. So again, I'll just reemphasize, the further a food appears from how it existed in nature, the less nutritious. So when everyone thinks about nutritious, well, not everyone, some people think about nutritious, we think of nature, just like I was saying, how it existed in nature, which makes you think of natural. The problem with natural is there is no legal definition. It does not mean the food is healthy. I don't want you to be fooled by packaging labels. There are a lot of things that exist in nature that we don't want to put into our bodies, such as lead. And there are many elements out there we don't want to put into our body. So just because something exists in nature doesn't mean we want it in our bodies. And also, manufacturers can put natural on there, but it doesn't really tell you anything about the product. So don't be fooled by this. And I'm going to pick on Nature Valley here because they have a fantastic example of how it's easy to think about this granola bar being good for you. Nature Valley. So the name implies natural, right? And then right underneath it, 100% natural. If you miss the nature, you got the natural. And then as a crunchy granola bar, you know, we have all those chewy granola bars which you think are unhealthy, but the crunchy old school ones must be healthy, right? 16 grams of whole grain. Okay, so it's already sounding like this is pretty good. You see the little wheat plant here, sun rays, so everything about this is telling you that it should be healthy. And maybe, you know, this is confusing, all these nutrition facts here. And I'm not even going to touch on this yet. We're going to go through this next week. What I'm going to do is go through the ingredient list. The ingredient that occurs in the highest amount in a product has to occur first on the list. And then it's a descending order. The one that's at the bottom is going to occur in the smallest amount. Let's go to this. So we see whole grain oats. Wow, well, that's fantastic. I mean, this must be healthy if it has whole grain oats. Well, let's start thinking about the rules. You don't want more than 5 items, right? So whole grain oats, 1, sugar, 2, canola oil, 3, dark chocolate pieces, 4, honey, 5, yellow corn flour, 6, soy flour, 7. Okay, now we have 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So 14 items. We've already broken one rule. Now, which of these can you recognize? Well, sugar, yes, okay, yellow corn, flour, soy lecithin. You may not recognize that one, although the rest of them you might. But you definitely, Again, as soon as you have things like soy lecithin, which is a food additive, it's actually a phospholipid. We'll learn about lipids in chapter 5. This is a key that this might not be very healthy. So it's already broken two of the rules, more than 5 items, and then also items that you can't recognize. Would your grandmother eat this? No, definitely wouldn't eat this, right? Is this product trying to tell you it's natural? I mean, it's natural and it's healthy? Yeah, so what's the rule? If a product's trying to tell you it's healthy, probably isn't going to be healthy. How long do you think these can sit on your shelf? I bet you could buy a box of these today, and in 2 years you could probably pull them out, and they are not going to rot. So it's kind of breaking all of our rules. But let's look at this. In the pink here, I've got sugar, honey, which is sugar, and this isn't raw honey from the farmer's market. This is highly refined processed honey, which is sugar, and brown sugar, syrup, 4 sugars. Now, this is a trick that manufacturers do. They divide up the types of sugar they have because now they don't have to list sugar as the first ingredient. Now, if all of these sugars were added together and you just used just one type of sugar, it's probably going to occur as your first ingredient. All of a sudden, if your first ingredient is sugar and your second ingredient is whole grain oats, that might set off an alarm. But it doesn't, and I get pretty sure that it would. Now, here's some other things. We have food additives, chocolate liqueur. That's an additive. We have soy lecithin here twice. Soy lecithin, our food additives. And then 2 sets of natural flavors. And we'll get into this at the very end of class. But natural flavors are made in the same place, same lab, as artificial flavors. So there's really nothing about a natural flavor that's natural. And we'll talk about this in more detail. So now what do we have? Nature Valley 100% natural granola bars have sugar, additive, and then basically flavors that have been made in the lab. Now, none of that, what if that tells you that it's healthy? Well, we do still have these whole grain oats, but the key here is when you look at a product, I don't want you to be sucked in by the one redeeming quality of it. If there are 8 other things screaming, this is not healthy, then it's not healthy. Just because you threw in a few oats doesn't make something healthy. But this is going to be just an overview of how manufacturers can fool you into thinking that you're making a good choice about a product.